previous video we were discussing about the Brook, the poem Brook. So now we'll be talking about the third stanza, that is Till Last by Phillips Farm I flow to join the brimming river, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So now here in the third stanza, what the brook says, it says Till Last by Phillips Farm I flow again. I is again the brook, because brook is depicting its own story. I kaun ho gaya? Brook. It says that at last I finally flow by Phillips Farm. Phillips Farm, now who is the Phillip? Nothing is a Phillip farmer. It's just we are talking about the farmer from where I flow, from his farm. So finally it joins the brimming river. Now वो वहाँ से क्रॉस करती हुई, फिलिप्स फार्म की क्रॉस करती हुई, नाउ इट फाइनली जॉइंस द ब्रिमिंग रिवर. सो फाइनली इट इज़ द डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ ब्रुक. द ब्रिमिंग मीन्स द फुल ऑफ वाटर, द रिवर विच इज़ फुल ऑफ वाटर, द ब्रिमिंग. दिस इज द ब्रुक डेस्टिनेशन, द ब्रिमिंग रिवर. एंड नाउ ब्रुक इज कंपेयरिंग इट सेल्फ विद द ह्यूमंस. फॉर मैन मे कम एंड मैन मे गो with their birth and death, they go away from this earth, like their birth and then they go away from this earth by death, with their death. So men are temporary, they are for time being, they are not forever, but I go on forever. But jo brook hai wo waisi hi rahegi, but men may come and men may go, because men are temporary. I is the brook. So brook says that I am eternal, I am eternal, I flow forever, I am unending, I never stop. So this is the main comparison which the poet wants to highlight between the brook and the human beings. Men are mortal, they are temporary, but brook is forever. Now we'll talk about the fourth stanza, that is I chatter over stony way in little sharps and trebles, I babble into edding bass, I babble on the pebbles. Now again, brook is telling about its journey. कि कैसे उसने अपनी journey start करी and finally reached to its destination, that is the brimming river. वो कैसे अलग अलग landmarks को cross करती है. Now these words, chatter, trebles, babble, these are all sound words. It makes different noises when it passes through different landforms. ये सारे sound words हैं. Now here, charter means to talk. Now here the brook says, I charter over stony ways. Stony means the big rocks. So it says, when I cross this big stones, I charter. I just make non-stop noise. Sirf main noise create karti hu. I make lot of noise. When I cross stony ways, and then it says little sharps and trebles. Now what is treble? High-pitched tones hoti hai. High-pitched tone ko hum trebles bolte hain. Now when there is a hurdle on the way of this brook, what the brook does, it changes its path. जब उसके brook में hurdles आते हैं, difficulties आती है, तो क्या करती है? Brook अपने path को change कर लेती है. With a sharp turn and it makes a very high pitch sound. वो अपनी turns change करती है with a high very pitch sound. I babble into adding bays. Now what is a bay? बेस द लैंड फॉर्म, जहाँ पर ऑल ऑफ अ सडन बहुत बड़ा एरिया होता है एंड वो वहाँ जाके इमर्ज हो जाती है. एंड इट देन फॉर्म्स द बबल इन द स्ट्रीम्स, द बबल्स दैट इट फॉर्म्स द ब्रुक. एंडिंग एडिंग मीन्स द स्पायरल मूवमेंट, जो कर्व और स्पायरल मूवमेंट ऑफ वाटर शुरू हो जाता है जब वो इमर्ज होती है. एंड द वाटर स्टार्ट्स मूविंग इन अ स्पायरल मूवमेंट एंड देन इट सेज आई बैबल ऑन द पेबल्स. नाउ बैबल मीन्स the sound made when one talks loudly. जो बहुत तेज noise आ जाती है, that means the pebbles. And pebbles, you know, all know the small stones which we are talking about. The small stones are known to be the pebbles. Now let's move on to the fifth stanza. With many a curve my banks I fret, by many a field and fallow, and many a fairy foreland set with willow weed and mellow. Now the brook is depicting with many curve my banks. कैसे उसको twist and turns लेती है. And now curve means twist. The twist and turn of the brook. Now stream doesn't flow in a straight line. जो पानी बहता है वो कोई straight line में थोड़ी ना बहता है. That has the twist and turns. Now, my banks I fret. Banks means the edges of the brook. जो साइड के एजेस होते हैं. Now we are talking about the banks I fret. Now banks means the edges of the brook and fret means gradually wear off. Then it says by many a field and fallow. Now fallow means land left uncultivated to regain fertility. Now brook says it crosses many fields and different lands and many a fairy fallen said वो इतने सारे troubles और hurdles को cross करती है. Crosses many fields and different lands. Now fairy tale story, not the realistic one, only the fairy tale story. Now foreland means the piece of land that extends into the sea. Now the land which also goes towards the sea, jo sea ke towards ja rahe. Willow wheat and mallow. Willow wheat means the kind of shrubs and mallow is a plant with hairy stems and leaves and pink, or white or purple. It is generally of pink, white and purple color. And the brook also crosses the different short plants and mallows. कैसे वो अपनी जर्नी को रेडी करती है और वो कैसे इन सबको क्रॉस करके वहाँ तक रीच होती है. That is the brimming river. Clear?